And now, it's Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk on CIAL 650. Now broadcasting from the Barber & Co. studios, here's your host, Tyler Grain.
Well, the Vancouver Whitecaps still control their own destiny as they got a much-needed point in San Jose. But is it? Was it? And will it be enough? Should be an interesting final match back at BC Place against the Colorado Rapids next weekend, who unfortunately the Caps haven't exactly had the greatest record against this season. 0 wins and 2 losses, more on that in a second. Europe had plenty to offer this week with European qualifying for Euro 2016. And of course the leagues got back into action, and perhaps the biggest soccer news in North America this week, the feud between U.S. men's national team head coach Jurgen Klinsmann and Major League Soccer Commissioner Don Garber. We'll get into that today on Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk. And good evening to you. Welcome to the program. We are broadcasting from the Barber & Co. studios on CIAL 650. My name's Tyler Green, on Twitter at TylerGreenFC. The show also available online worldwide at www.cil650.com. Thank you for listening. The first half kickoff is brought to you by KO, Kevin O'Toole, and findaproperty.ca. Whether you're looking to sell a home or find the perfect spot for you, Kevin can help you out at findaproperty.ca. Whether it's a place close to your favorite watering hole to watch the match, maybe close to BC Place to walk to and from the game, or maybe a backyard big enough to have your own pitch, Kevin will help you find that perfect home. Get the full details at findaproperty.ca. Kevin O'Toole, licensed realtor with Prudential Sussex Realty, online at findaproperty.ca. The Vancouver Whitecaps missed an opportunity to really put all the pressure on Portland, forcing them into a must-win situation. Yeah, the Whitecaps still control their own destiny, but a slip-up as simple as a draw against Colorado next weekend could spell certain doom for the Whitecaps. And let's not forget that Vancouver hasn't exactly ripped Colorado to shreds this season. They lost at BC Play Stadium 2-1. They also lost 2-0 to the Rapids in Colorado. And Vancouver also has a bit of a bad habit of playing down to the competition, much like they did against San Jose this evening. But it brings us to tonight's Barber Poll presented by barberandco.ca. How confident are you in the Whitecaps heading into this final match of the regular season and a spot in the Major League Soccer playoffs? You can tweet us your thoughts with the hashtag BarberPoll on Twitter at SoccerTalk650 or TylerGreenFC. You can also email us at SoccerTalk650@gmail.com, or you can give us a buzz at 604-280-0650. And as always, you can comment on our Facebook page, facebook.com/SoccerTalkVan. Go to it, like it. Your life will be better for it. The Barber Poll is brought to you by Barber & Co. Gastown, Yaletown, the Financial District, Canby and 18th, and the fantastic new spot on the corner of Main and 12th. I'm once again going there this week to get a new haircut. Got the family photos with my daughter this week. Got to look good. So I'm going to Barber & Co. for a visit to get the new haircut. BarberandCo.ca, that's BarberandCo.ca. They are on Twitter at Barber & Co. Elsewhere in Major League Soccer, Toronto FC missing out on the playoffs yet again for the 8th time in their history. And it's been really tough out there for the Toronto FC fans. I think a lot of them probably quite upset, hoping that this could finally be their year, but unfortunately, no. With so many seasons, Toronto FC has basically changed everything from the top to the bottom after failing to make the postseason. So perhaps this year Toronto might stay the course and don't make any changes to your GM or coach. Or should they make some alterations? We'll speak with John Molinaro, the chief soccer reporter for Sportsnet.ca, about that very topic. He covers Toronto FC on a regular basis, so we'll speak with John at about 11:15 this evening about TFC, about what they need to do. Do they make changes? Is Greg Vanney the guy that can take Toronto FC to that next step as coach? And John has also covered Toronto FC, because the one thing that Toronto FC has been able to do is make CONCACAF Champions League on a fairly regular basis. And the Vancouver Whitecaps are in because Toronto FC drew today. So Vancouver made it in before they even played tonight. What does it mean for Vancouver, for the fans, and for the club to make it into CONCACAF Champions League? We'll talk to John Molinaro about that a little bit later on in the second half of the program. Plus, of course, as always, we'll connect with expert physios David Sandals. He'll be by to speak about injuries at 11 p.m. Frank Lampard picked up a thigh injury. Credit again. We've talked about this a lot of times with David Sandals, but credit again to the Whitecaps medical staff. Kakuta Mane had a bit of a collision last week, had the contusion on the, for the lack of a better term, on the butt. Pedro Morales went down with what they were calling a hamstring strain, but he was back. Wasn't overly effective today, I don't think, but he was back and able to play. So we'll talk to David Sandals all about that. And David, at Expert Physio, has had an influx of ankle injuries this week. So we'll talk a little bit about ankle injuries with David Sandals coming up at 11 o'clock here on Key of Vancouver Soccer Talk. Over in Europe, it's been an interesting week. What's the biggest surprise for you? We've seen Germany not at their best in Euro qualifying. Saw a 15-year-old debut for Norway. Iceland has been performing exceptionally well in Euro qualifying, and a drone takes over between Serbia and Albania in league action. Southampton just destroying Sunderland today. Are these guys for real? It's pretty impressive. And as I mentioned about David Sandals coming on the program, Frank Lampard stretchered off today, quietly putting together a very solid start to his season in the Premier League, his final season in the Premier League, or half season as it were. But, you know, now with that injury, he was stretchered off. He's going for scans. If it's really serious, it could hamper his debut for Toronto, for New York City FC. So that's going to be an interesting thing to keep an eye on there with Frank Lampard. This, of course, is Key of Vancouver Soccer Talk. It's on CL 650 Radio in Vancouver. And get into Key of Vancouver right now, because free lifetime oil changes, car washes, and get this, free lifetime airport parking and shuttle service. It's only at BC's number one Kia dealership at 396 Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon. KiaVancouver.com. And right now they're raising money as well in the month of October here for breast cancer research, etc. So they're collecting money for the Breast Cancer Society of BC. It's all month long for the entire month of October. So really, you know, about 13 days left here. So get in there, get into Kia Vancouver and help out. Maybe it's, you know, a buck or two. But it would be great. I'm going to be heading in there in a couple weeks to take part in that free car wash services. So I'll be donating some money when I get in to the good folks over at Kia Vancouver. Up next on the program, Simon and I will get into the starting 11. There's obviously some teams surprising in both aspects, struggling and succeeding in Euro qualifying. We'll talk about that. The Garber and Klinsmann battle begins. Well, was any of those guys right? And, you know, how did it do? Did it do good things for soccer? Canada played at Colombia. No Whitecaps really taking part. Russell Tybert missing. Most noticeable. Notable cap, I guess. What does he need to do to end his, seemingly an exile from the Canadian national team? And is this the worst season in Toronto FC history? Just some of the questions we'll answer in the starting 11 when Simon Fudge and myself debate it next.
Follow us on Twitter at SoccerTalk650 and at TylerGreenFC. This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on CIL 650.
Pain or injury slowing you down? Take it to the choice of many top athletes. Expert Physio. Serving the Lower Mainland for over 35 years, the team at Expert Physio is dedicated to individualized care with specialized services such as orthotics, acupuncture, IMS, plus dizziness, pelvic floor, and certified hand therapies. Over 300 physicians referred to Expert Physio last year, and 100% of patients surveyed said they choose Expert Physio again. You're in good hands with Expert Physio. Burnaby Heights or at 8 Rinks. ExpertPhysio.ca.
Not that your stylist at the salon isn't doing a good job, but man, you deserve the big red leather barber chair experience of Barber & Co. Here's how it works. Go to barberandco.ca. Book your appointment at one of the five barber shops in Gastown, Yaletown, the Financial District, Cambie at 18th, and now Main Street and 12th Avenue. You can just walk in, too, and get your hair cut, hot shave, buzz cut, fade, or beard trim experience. A great wedding party idea, too. Barberandco.ca.
Nearly 70 years ago, Charlie Wolford first started fixing loggers' boots. He did such a good job, loggers said if he'd make boots from scratch, they'd buy them and tell their buddies. Charlie named his brand Dayton. And ever since, Dayton Boots has put the same craftsmanship and love in every pair built right here in Vancouver. Times change, but the quality in every handcrafted pair of Dayton Boots never has. Mention Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk and take 10% off Dayton Boots, 2250 East Hastings. Dayton, where a legend that lasts. Money.
It's Your Money with Fred Snyder.
You take 100 people to start at equal today at the age of 25. By the time they end up at 65, one is rich or well-to-do, five are still working, 36 are dead, and the rest might just as well be dead. There's 54 of them. They're dead broke, dependent on family and state. And the main reason is they don't have the knowledge, they didn't have the financial plan, and we're providing you with all that here on this show.
Fred Snyder, Sunday mornings 9 to 11 on Smooth and Easy, CIL 650.
Hi, I'm Jack McIver. When a customer comes to our store after shopping around and see what they haven't seen in other appliance stores, washers and dryers, plain and simple. 3 years full guarantee, 5 years guarantee on the motor, 10 years on the transmission, big capacity, much better performance, our professional delivery and installation, all for less than the other guys. And after 50 years in business, McIver's is the best at what we do. McIver's, we're at 610 Southeast Marine Drive. Call 879-5222 or visit us on the net at McIver's.biz.
This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on CIL 650. Now broadcasting from the Barber & Co. studios. Here's your host, Tyler Green. Calling
all the stars to fall. Whitecaps! A scoreless draw in San Jose. Simon and I will discuss that in around 15 minutes from now, including, you know, just this performance that they had tonight. And as much as, you know, I think a lot of people looked at the schedule down the stretch and saw Portland playing Real Salt Lake and FC Dallas and thinking, yeah, you know what? I think we got this. But Vancouver hasn't had much luck against the Colorado Rapids, losing twice to them this season, and continuing to play down to the competition, as they kind of did against San Jose earlier tonight. Don't forget, mention Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk. Take 10% off quality handcrafted right here in BC. Dayton Boots, 2250 East Hastings, online at daytonboots.com. It is starting 11 time. You can tweet us your thoughts on the starting 11, as always. I'm on Twitter at TylerGreenFC. Goal.com writer and my co-host here on the program is at SimonFudge74. And of course, the show is Soccer Talk 650. And we'll start with number one on the starting 11. And Simon, we head to Europe. And which team has surprised you the most, whether it's been struggling or succeeding in Euro 2016 qualifying?
Without question, it's Iceland. Three wins out of three in Group A, looking good and strong. Incredibly impressive in their last qualifying game home to the Netherlands, first time they'd ever beaten them in, I think, 11 tries. A country of 325,000 people who have gone out of their way since the turn of the millennium to really work on their development. And it's paid dividends, and the group of players that they have now that played at the European Under-21 Championships a couple of years ago is really coming good. I mean, they came within a whisker of going to the World Cup, believe it or not, if they got past Croatia in a playoff. So they're the ones that are really impressing me right now. And for the size of country, it's a particularly remarkable achievement to this point.
For me, it's Germany, and it's of the bad variety that they're kind of standing out for me. You know, they kicked it off with a great success, picking up all 3 points, but then they lose to Poland, and they didn't look good that great doing so, and then they go and play the Republic of Ireland and had the lead, gave it up so late in the end to get just the single point, which I think if you're the Irish, you're loving, because it was in Germany, and to go in and steal a point is great. But you know, if you're German and you're a Germany fan, or you're the German team, I think you're a little bit surprised and shocked, and it has just not gone well for them to start this campaign. Call it maybe a bit of a World Cup hangover, trying to get that right mix after a bunch of players have retired from the competition, from the national team. A lot of injuries as well. I look back and I hearken back to a while ago when, Germany was so close and they had all these young players and they had all that drive, guys like Lahm, Schweinsteiger, Mertesacker, there were a lot of young players, even a Lukas Podolski as well. Those guys, they had that drive, they had that ambition of, we came so close, now we've got to take that to the next level, and eventually they were able to win the World Cup. And now there's a lot of young guys that have already won the World Cup, and I wonder if maybe there's that little bit of a hangover of thinking, maybe it's a little too easy for us, but they've been struggling, and it's surprised me quite a bit.
I think they'll come back. I wouldn't be too concerned about if you're a Germany fan. Number two, how stiff of a ban on Serbia and or Albania should there be for what we call Dronegate in Tuesday's Euro 2016 qualifying match that was abandoned in Belgrade?
I think it's rather unfortunate as to what happened in terms of the drone coming in. Not something that either team could really control. We see drones everywhere. It's something that's just growing and growing. So I think it would be a little bit difficult to necessarily be able to put a stop to that in terms of, being able to, what are you supposed to do? Put a net over the roof to make sure that doesn't happen. But at the same time, with what happened on the field, with some of the antics that happened, I think that's something that needs to be looked at. And when these two teams play again, I think in both of their home matches against one another, it should be on neutral ground, closed stadium. And I think that's probably the gist of it. The extent that I would give for a ban.
Yeah, I would say that playing both their qualifiers, if they replay the abandoned one and the other one that was supposed to be played in Tirana and Albania, they should be played on neutral grounds. Failing that, if they're going to play them in both countries, they have to be done behind closed doors. It's the only other option around. Both countries' FAs probably should be fine, more so for the actions that happened on the pitch. You're right about the drone itself and flying in. The concerning thing with that is what other people out there are going to get ideas in mm-hmm. other big games, particularly like big European Champions League games, trying to fly a drone in like that. I mean, that's where the sort of a dangerous precedence has been set, but that's almost another issue entirely. both, I think they'll have to clamp down UEFA on both FAs, particularly because of a lot of the rhetoric that's come out after the fact, particularly from the Albanian FA. A lot of it was just uncalled for and totally unnecessary, so I think there's going to have to be punishment in that regard. And yeah, I think the fact that these two countries are so politically charged, they've got to be playing in venues that are either neutral or behind closed doors.
Yeah, and I would agree that, you know, it is a scary thought, and I didn't really even think about that, about, you know, somebody getting now an idea about a drone and flying something in there. It is kind of scary to think about when you look at that aspect. Number three on the starting 11, how many British home nations, and when we talk about the home nations, it's England, it's Northern Ireland, it's Wales, Scotland. How many of those make Euro 2016?
I think three of them do, and I'm liking Northern Ireland and Wales to join England at Euro 2016. What a start for the Ulstermen, Northern Ireland. I mean the first two games were relatively ones that they could have got, but they've played well and got to get results in both of them. But to go to Greece, this is a team that made, I think, was it the last eight of the World Cup, and to win there and look impressive doing it, just remarkable. Wales could have been better, but they're still in the mix. They haven't played any of the tougher teams in their group yet. So I look at those three countries, and I think they're in a very good position, being that it's automatic top two that qualify, and the third place team gets the playoff. I think Scotland's in tough because of the fact they're in Germany's group. Poland have started well in there, and the Republic of Ireland are very much in the mix, having gotten that draw. Scotland's home game next month at Celtic Park against the Republic of Ireland is massive now, because we're for both countries, really. One of those two teams has to take maximum points in that game, because if they have any aspirations of making the tournament finals.
I think we're in agreement that England's going to get there. I do like what you're saying about the fact that you know, Northern Ireland has really come out to a flying start there. And you know, I really like to see what they are doing right now. And I have to think that at some point, you know, Belgium and even Bosnia and Herzegovina are going to get things going for there. And I think Wales is going to be that sort of, is that team that's sort of on the cusp. You think they're going to make it?
Think so. Maybe just.
I'm going to say they're not. I'll go against you and say that I think they'll fall out of it.
That's a fair shout. It's a fair shout. Number four, Norway.
It's early.
Yeah, Norway have been performing relatively well in Euro 2016 qualifying so far, but really made the news by debuting 15-year-old Martin Odegaard this week against Bulgaria. He became the youngest player in European Championship qualifying history at 15 years of age. Is that too young to make your senior international debut?
You know what? I think if you're good enough and you're at a level that you can help your team, and you're at a level that you're not going to hurt your team, but you are good enough to really, I think, step in there, play, and help your team, I think all the best. I think you have the ability. Why not? Let's see you go out there. I know 15-year-old kids that are bigger than 25-year-old guys. So I don't think size is an issue, you know, especially in soccer, because there's a lot of very tiny players right now that have overcome a lot of things. All the best to him. You know, if he's good enough at 15 years of age, go for it.
Absolutely agree. If you have the talent, you're good enough, and you're certainly old enough to be able to play at senior international level, and that should be the only criteria for anyone like an Odegaard, who sounds to me like a special player. I haven't seen enough of him, but my goodness, is he being heavily courted. I had a really interesting chat this week with Marius Rovde, who's Norwegian, the Whitecaps goalkeeping coach, and he said to me that his father and both him have been taken out to dinner by representatives of Barcelona and Real Madrid on two separate occasions. So he plays for a club in the Norwegian Tippeligaen League called Strøm Godset, and so it's basically which of the big players is going to grab him out there. Rovde thinks that he's better suited to go to Spain than to go to the English Premier League based on his physical size and the way that he plays.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting indeed. Number five on the starting 11, the Indian Super League debuted with many, quote, old-timers signing up. Have they gone for the paycheck, or are they looking to help the league grow?
I think they've gone for a bit of everything. I would say paycheck certainly would be up there. Sort of the new experience of a country that many have not been to, but a lot of people haven't been to before, is always curious. I mean, you know, going back to the days of the British Empire, India was always seemingly this massive romantic place. And I still think in a lot of ways it holds that kind of romanticism for people. So for footballers, past and present, if they're in their prime or not, it's probably one of the things that they're into it. And sure, there's a bit of soccer's growth to go along with it as well. They probably think, well, we could be part of something here that could maybe get people who are so mad about cricket to get on and get into soccer as well.
I think for the most part, it's guys that are going for the paycheck right now. They're looking to cash in their final couple of years. They know that they probably can breeze through a lot of these games, not take it too seriously. It's not as, you know, as much as MLS, I think, is considered a retirement league by a lot. There are those games of, you know, look at today, for example. If you're an older player and you've come over, you're getting up for that game, say, between Vancouver. If you're on Vancouver looking against San Jose because you want to make those playoffs. I don't know if there's that drive there in India right now or that cachet of playing there. So I think a lot of guys are going for the paycheck.
That's fair enough. But they even created the Indian Premier League for cricket in the same vein, even though they do get the in-prime cricket.
And let's not forget, India did have a league a couple years ago. That's what happened to that?
Well, that I think this is what it is now, was supposed to be that then, and one a certain Tater Tortoson was supposed to be part of it, as far as I know.
So who knows how long this one will last.
Yeah, exactly. Number six, the Garber Klinsmann verbal brado took over the soccer world this week, at least in North America. Who, if any, was right?
You know what? It's one of those things. I think that Jurgen Klinsmann had some comments that weren't offside by any stretch. He was discussing the thought that, hey, you know what? Some guys might be taking a step back. And that's all fair and good. And so I've got a couple different parts to this answer. One, I think that's all fair and good. But at the same time, look at guys like Josie Altidore, Breck Shea. Going over to England hasn't helped their career. It hasn't done anything for them in their, you know, seemingly in their ability right now, because they're not playing games. And that's the whole point of going over. I could go over and try to play for a side in England, like Division 10 or something like that. In saying that I'm going over, is that a step up if I'm never playing? No. You know what? Guys need to play in order to get better or in order to keep fit, etc. At the same time, Garber just had to defend his league so much that I think he just completely missed the point. It made it more of a news story. So I think both guys were kind of wrong in some of the things that they said. I think both of them were kind of right. And I think it was good for soccer, though, because it got a lot of people talking. And I think it got a lot of people that don't necessarily cover soccer on a regular basis talking about the argument as well.
Yeah, it felt to me like both were right and wrong. But again, like you say, there were so many, it was sort of multi-layered to all of this. Where Klinsmann made a whole pile of legitimate points, and I feel in a lot of ways he got his point across far better, because he went out of his way to explain himself in terms of saying, okay, you know, the likes of Dempsey and Bradley have come back, and really their play has stepped down. But then there was also the point made, you think about, you know, playing time. Well, look at where they were, Spurs in the case of Dempsey and Bradley, Roma, not getting any playing time when they were there. That's one of the reasons they kind of came back to be mainstays in the teams that they're in right now. So there is that kind of thing. I think Garber let his emotions get the better of him, because obviously he did what he had to do in defending the league, and he had his right to do that. But then he really took it far too far in terms of what he said, and then put out a lot of opinions, especially the one about his thoughts on Landon Donovan being left out of the U.S. World Cup squad. I think There he was offside. Why he had to go over that and cross over that line and really then make it a bit personal and now make it a real tete-a-tete kind of battle with Klinsmann. Great for the press and great for maybe sort of getting some attention, as you say, in the sport of soccer. But it was in some ways for me a bit unnecessary for what one argument was making and what the other person trying to rebuttal it.
Yeah, and, you know, for me, Landon Donovan is one of the greatest examples of Major League Soccer in not necessarily hurting his play. Landon Donovan never really had any tremendous overall success going over to Europe. But he had just scored a boatload of goals in Major League Soccer, and he's pretty much scored about a goal every three games for the U.S. men's national team. So playing in Major League Soccer in that environment never hindered his international play. And sometimes it's more about getting playing time than anything else.
That's right.
Right now, Kia Vancouver is offering free oil changes, car washes, and airport parking and shuttle service only at BC's number one Kia dealership, Kia Vancouver, 396 Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon, kiavancouver.com. And a player that's playing in BC is Russell Tybert. And, well, he wasn't on the Canadian men's national team when they played Colombia earlier this week when the Canadian team lost 1-0. Tybert, the most notable cap missing from that roster, and he seems to be in a bit of a exile from that Canadian squad. What does he need to do to end that exile and make the team?
Well, the obvious one is just to keep working hard and playing well, and in within that as well, continue to show himself to be a leader on the pitch as well as off of it. I think those are the real things that he needs to show, because then that can then turn around on Benito Flooring. He can see that he brings a lot of those various qualities into this group. I'm thinking there's going to be some more meeting and dialogue between, you know, Russell and maybe Carl Robinson and with Benito and the national team. That's all he can really do. My only real kind of concern for Russell's sake is the fact that in the last two games, from the good performances that Canada have had, I'm starting to see Benito probably starting to put together a core of players here that's kind of to take shape. And the more that Russell Tybert isn't part of that, the more challenging I think it might become for him to get into that setup.
For me, it's like you said, he's got to continue to perform the way he has on the field for the Vancouver Whitecaps and continue to improve his game in regards to that. Off the field, I think it's as simple as saying to Floro, and you know, we've heard some rumors that you know, it's the way that he's sort of held himself in and spoken while on the national team, maybe taken a few things for granted. But I think if you're Russell Tybert and you want back in, you simply say to Benito Floro, I want to play, I'm available whenever you call me, and I will do whatever you need me to do on that team, whether that's a substitute, whether that's a starting player, but I will do what you need. And I think it's as simple as that.
I agree. Number 8 on the starting 11. Is this the worst season for Toronto FC in their entire history?
Yeah, I think it is. And, you know, they've had worse records than this. They've had games where they haven't won a game in, you know, starting the season in 10 games, etc. But I think this is the worst season in their history simply because of all the hope that they had at the start of the year, with guys like Jermaine Defoe and Michael Bradley coming into this roster. They kept Ryan Nelson as the coach in that, hey, we don't want to change too many things. And there was all this hype, all this excitement coming into this league, this season, and they just failed once again to make it. And I think this is the worst season on record for Toronto FC.
I agree. In many ways, I think it is as well. So much money spent and so much hype and promise put out there that we all had to endure, particularly early in the new year. And what we get, the same result. To me, the enduring problem with Toronto FC is that they have had this habit of always adding pieces, no matter how big a size they are, but never getting the shape of the team out. And this is the big job that Tim Bezpachenko, their GM, and Greg Vanney, their head coach, have got now, to shape out this team. You have to be given a lot of credit, Tyler. I know you're a modest man, but you pointed out right at the beginning of the year, in the hype of all of this Defoe and Bradley coming in, that they still had issues at center back. So what has everyone been pointing to in terms of where their issues are? It's at center back. Also the absence of Matias Laba, how much they've missed him potentially, or some kind of defensive midfielder as well. So now everyone's saying that they need to get all of these pieces in. We wait and see if Bezpachenko and Vanny can deliver with all of that. But, you know, it is, for me, the worst season ever, because they put so much stock and say and put the messaging out, this was going to be different. And by Labor Day, it all turned out to be the beginning of more of the same.
I barely remember what I said 2 weeks ago, Simon, so you have a better memory than I do.
Remember it very clearly, and it's just amazing how it's risen to the surface, and now it's like how it's what everyone is saying about this team. So it's interesting. Yeah.
Number 9 on the starting 11, Seattle Sounders and Portland Timbers both announced USL Pro teams this week that will start in 2015. How imperative is it that the Caps begin next season?
It's imperative. They need to get their act together quickly and get this done because, these are two big organizations to the south of them that have gone and structured themselves in a very similar way with great foundations, and they've already got that extra piece in place, that legitimate sort of reserve football structure that everyone seems to want to sign up to now. They've got it, they've got it in place, they know where they're going to play, they know where they're going to do it. Fine, done. The Whitecaps have paid dearly for having taken a terribly misguided strategy of putting all their eggs in the basket on U.S. Minster and having spent all the time and wasting it in terms of trying to make that happen and having it just basically blow up in their face. They've got to do something about this and do it quickly.
Yeah, I would agree. And more so, you know, as much as... Yeah, things fell apart in New West, but I think they have to get it done. Even if they just play at UBC for a year until they have it figured out, they need to get it done, because I look at Bryce Alderson, who, you know, has played 0 minutes in Major League. Paulo Tornaghi, another guy. We saw earlier tonight David Oestead go down, and sort of those tense moments of, is he going to get up? Is he going to be okay? Well, Tornaghi hasn't played this year in Major League Soccer. He didn't even play in the Amway Canadian Championship games. So, you know, is he going to be ready? Is he going to be good to go? So there's things like that that I think these guys need to get out. They need to get minutes. They need to play minutes in order to develop them. This year for me is as much as Bryce Alderson is going to improve by training with the first team, he's also just missing so much time playing that I think that is also a detriment on his future progression, and they need to get that USL Pro team. They need to be in control of that.
Here's another quick point I wanted to make, and I'd be interested to see what Seattle, Portland, Salt Lake's, and LA's super draft strategy is going to be, because they now have these USL Pro teams. If they make the effort to go take a rougher diamond in the draft for the fact that they know that they can put that player in USL Pro for at least a season or two, you know, someone that under the old setup without that reserve football there, see if he could go, but then eventually release him at the end of the day.
Yeah, you
know, that's something that Vancouver could do, and you know, you never know, that could end up paying dividends.
Also depends on where you draft, because if you're picking number two and you've got almost a can't beat pick, you're gonna take that can't beat pick.
Yeah. Number 10, same theme, USL Pro. If the Caps do get a USL Pro side, who would you name as head coach?
And for me, it's without a doubt, Nick Dazovic would be my coach of that team. Local guy that lives in the area, or did so before he went down to San Jose to coach. He's had professional experience in Major League Soccer. He's coached the young players with the Canadian U20 squad. And I think he would be the perfect fit here. He would be, you know, he, I think, would be a great player to be able to bring players through. He's got that pedigree of actually playing the game in some professional leagues around the country, around the world. He's been on the Canadian men's national team, so he wouldn't be that kind of coach that you say, well, where did you play? What experience do you have? I think he would have the respect of those young players, and I think he would do a fantastic job, and I would put my money on Nick Dazovic to be the coach if I was in charge.
Totally agree. I'd like to see Nick Dazovic take it on, and take on this team for many of the same reasons you point out. Experience in coaching young players. He would be a very good fit all round for that, because unlike, I think, in the case of the Whitecaps and the sort of the higher stature and the higher quality of player that's coming from around the world that plays on that side, you've got more of a local player that's going to play in a prospective USL Pro Whitecaps side. So to have a coach that's a local guy as well gives a good connection to the community, and people can really rally around it depending on wherever they're based in the Lower Mainland.
And finally, on the starting 11, the Whitecaps will know their fate just after they kick off next week. They might know that they're in the playoffs at around the 15-minute mark of next week's game. So should Major League Soccer play all the final matches of the regular season at the same time?
It would make sense, but I think not just TV contracts, but the different time zones that the teams play in is the thing that will work against that at the end of the day for me. I think it's very tricky. You can never figure out which are going to be the key important games in your final right day of the regular season until pretty much the week before. So there's kind of that to think about as well. But I just think because we're not a league that's based in one time zone, that's a very challenging thing to do, as much as it makes sense.
I think you have to do it. For me, it would make complete sense. RSL plays on Wednesday. If they somehow lose against Chivas USA, FC Dallas knows where they're going to finish in the standings and can pretty much play 11 players that have maybe never seen the field yet this season, because they have nothing to play for. They're not going to move up or down in the standings, and that's going to give Portland a huge advantage. You could do that anyway, but if you have something to play for, well, that's not going to happen. And so they might know their fate. There's also games, you know, that could, guys might determine where they're going to be. You know, if this was the final weekend and Portland played on a Friday and lost, well, Vancouver would then have that opportunity to go and play all their lesser guys and get other guys a rest. And that, I think, also just doesn't do much for the fans. So I think you have to – I know there's a lot of different details that have to be worked out, whether it's stadium availability, TV, etc., but I would love to see all the final games on the final day all at the same time. And as much as, hey, it's 4 o'clock, Whitecaps played half their games here, that's 7 o'clock at night. You can have an afternoon game. Time zones, I don't think, are going to play much of a factor. It's only 3 hours.
So you do it like on a Saturday at the sort of like an afternoon, sort of like 4 Eastern and 1 Pacific kind of thing,
yeah,
all at the same time.
Get them all at the same time. And I know that there's 19 teams this year, so that might be a little bit difficult. Somebody might have to play against themselves. But
well, yeah. There you go.
All the MLS scores in a minute, and we'll also get into some of the specifics about the Whitecaps and San Jose 0-0 draw next.
Follow us on Twitter at SoccerTalk650 and at Tyler Green FC. This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on Sea Isle 650. Kia's Gear Up and Save event is on now at Kia Vancouver. So come score on most 2015 models with ultra-low weekly payments and 0% financing for 84 months. Plus, get ready for victory with Kia's available winter-ready features. But hurry, this is a limited-time offer. So gear up and save. And remember, only Kia Vancouver gives you free lifetime car washes, oil changes, and free airport shuttle and parking with your new Kia purchase. Kia Vancouver, Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon, and KiaVancouver.com.
Pain or injury slowing you down? Take it to the choice of many top athletes. Expert Physio. Serving the Lower Mainland for over 35 years, the team at Expert Physio is dedicated to individualized care with specialized services such as orthotics, acupuncture, IMS, plus dizziness, pelvic floor, and certified hand therapies. Over 300 physicians referred to Expert Physio last year, and 100% of patients surveyed said they choose Expert Physio again. You're in good hands with Expert Physio. Burnaby Heights or at 8 Rinks. ExpertPhysio.ca.
The family story begins generations ago on Via Tevere, a street in the heart of Naples, where food was the celebration of life. Today, in East Van, Via Tevere Pizzeria Napoletana honors their family heritage with La Vera Pizza Napoletana, pizza that showcases authentic Neapolitan ingredients and the time-honored tradition of wood-fired cooking. Come experience La Vera Pizza Napoletana, true Neapolitan pizza, at Via Tevere Pizzeria, 1190 Victoria Drive, and look for the Via Tevere Neapolitan Express food cart around town.
The Straight Razor Shave, a leading man classic. Steady hand coaxing the rugged face back to smoothness. This nearly lost art has found revival at Barber & Co. Hot towel, straight edge blade, and your face. It's an experience that reminds you you're alive. You're a man in the company of history's finest men. Start at barberandco.ca. Pick your barber shop in Yale Town, Gastown, the Financial District, Cambiet 18th, and now Main Street and 12th Avenue. And relax into the big leather chair for the shave of your life.
The truth is, you just don't know what to do anymore. You worry about mom or dad being home alone. You worry if they're eating, if they're getting out, if they're lonely. Retirement Concepts is here to tell you seniors living isn't what it used to be. It's all about a balance of chef-inspired good meals, good friends, and beautiful accommodations.
Join us for a complimentary meal and personal visit. Go to retirementconcepts.com to find a retirement community close to you.
So nice to come home to. retirementconcepts.com.
Jesus spoke clearly of the importance of prayer. He spoke of going into the closet, so to speak, shutting the door, and praying to God. Shutting out the empty or harmful chatter of materialistic thinking through listening to what God is telling us in prayer can make a world of difference to our well-being. Hear about this on the next radio edition of the Christian Science Sentinel.
Listen for the Christian Science Sentinel, Sunday mornings at 8:30 on Sea Isle 650.
This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on Sea Isle 650. Now broadcasting from the Barber & Co. studios, here's your host, Tyler Green.
Caps 0-0 draw with the Earthquakes. Discuss that in a matter of moments, but first let's check the rest of the MLS scores. Brought to you by Dayton Boots, DaytonBoots.com. Simon?
Yes, Thursday night, Houston Dynamo fall 2-1 to the New England Revolution. Lee Wynn can't stop scoring two goals in that game for the Revs. Last night, it was Portland Timbers 0, Rail Salt Lake 0. Four games today in MLS. Toronto Sees playoff hopes are done. They drew 1-1 with the Montreal Impact in the Canadian Derby. It was Colorado Rapids 0, FC Dallas 1. Blas Perez with the winner there. Philadelphia Union beating Sporting Kansas City by 2-1, and DC United beat Chicago Fire by 2-1. There are two games tomorrow. New York Red Bulls host the Columbus Crew, and the big one to deal with the matter of the Supporter Shield, LA Galaxy hosting the Seattle Sounders.
All he does is win. That was the MLS scoreboard.
Certainly does, yeah.
Brought to you by Dayton Boots. Mention Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk. Take 10% off quality handcrafted right here in BC. Dayton Boots, 2250 East Hastings. Dayton Boot, where the legend that lasts, DaytonBoots.com. Still to come on the program, David Sandals talking injuries as he does each and every week at 11 o'clock. And, of course, TFC, the story there with John Molinaro at 11:15 from Sportsnet. Right now, Kia Vancouver offering free oil changes, car washes, airport parking, and shuttle service at BC's number one Kia dealership, Kia Vancouver, 396 Southwest Marine Drive at YukonKiaVancouver.com. Simon, not the greatest result in terms of the Whitecaps today. They got the single point, and now it still in control of their own destiny. But one of those, a little bit of a missed opportunity, because they had the opportunity to really to win the game, show that they can play some of the weaker teams, and really put the pressure all on Portland, forcing Portland to really basically have to win to get in. And now it's, you know, it's not as simple as that.
No,
the Whitecaps, really, as much as they do control their own destiny, you know, a little slip up here from the Whitecaps, and it's all over for them.
That's the thing, and that's where 3 points tonight would have been so valuable, is that it just, you know, it would have just been win or bust for Portland. Now, Portland know full well they can go to Dallas, and if they get 3 points, it's role reversal. Then they put the pressure on Vancouver. So, yeah, it was an opportunity missed tonight, even though you watched the game and you could watch it once or a million times. There wasn't enough from either side that you could say they deserved to win the game. We got one quality chance from each team, and both goalkeepers came up with the save. Other than that, it was the right result in the end, but it was an opportunity lost. But a tricky game, a difficult place to play, narrow, really is a kind of a north-south type of style of soccer when you play at Buckshaw Stadium. Can't get a lot of width out there. And I think, you know, because the Whitecaps like to use as much of the width as they can on a pitch, I think being restricted by the size of it kind of was one of the things they probably took away from the way they may have wanted to play or they like to play. And unfortunately, yeah, it led to them not being able to take maximum points probably.
And you know, here Vancouver is 1 point ahead of Portland and into that fifth spot. They can't get any higher than fifth. They can drop to sixth spot in the Western Conference. And if Portland just gets a single point next weekend, which, you know, it's very difficult to go down and play in Dallas, so you would think that the Whitecaps do have a bit of an advantage there in you know, Portland not getting a full 3 points. But if Portland just gets a single point and Vancouver loses, Portland's in.
That's right.
So, yeah, you know, there is pressure in Vancouver, and it would have been so nice to be able to have a little bit of that breathing room this week to get the win, knowing that next week, okay, now we only need that single point. We have that fallback plan because, you know, as I mentioned earlier, that you know, they have just haven't done that well against Colorado this season. And, yeah, things can change. But at the same time, you know, there's a lot of guys on that Rapids team that are looking to play for their jobs next week.
Exactly. But that's where Vancouver need to sort of particularly look at the two games that they have with Colorado, particularly the last home game here where Jose Mari scored two wonderful goals in that game. The thing that they need to think particularly about that game was that was a home game where they really let it go. And I think it was the Matias Laba red card, you know, where he handled the ball with his arm, mm-hmm. got himself sent off. And they always looked at, I think, at that game as being one that got away from them. And they've got to try and take it as the approach of they owe the Colorado Rapids one on that.
So. Quickly, about tonight's performance, David Osted, very good in goal. Johnny Leverone filled in, I thought, very nicely. Pedro Morales, not the greatest game from him. Maybe still some hampered by a little bit of that injury from last week. Moro Rosales, not as sharp as we've seen him of late. But Darren Maddox off the bench looked like a different player in this game today.
He did. He was very good. Also, I think Christian Kofi and Fernandez were good and positive and contributing. Maybe if they came on 5-10 minutes earlier, could have made the difference. But yeah, Darren Maddox was excellent tonight. That was a good sign.
We'll talk more about this in the second half of the program here on Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk. It was, some very nice performances from some of those players, and it's going to be very interesting to see how Carl Robinson lays out his lineup next weekend. Quick break here, but back with the latest news, notes, and rumors from around the globe next.
Follow us on Twitter at SoccerTalk650 and at Tyler Green FC. This is Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk on Sea Isle 650.
Vancouver Street Soccer League is the beautiful game at its finest. Teams of men and women who are homeless, have recently been homeless, or are at risk for homelessness get together to train and play matches. It's great fun that builds skill and confidence, and the league sent players to 4 consecutive Homeless World Cups in Milan, Rio de Janeiro, Paris, Mexico City, and Poland. Find out more at VancouverStreetSoccer.com.
Vancouver Street Soccer League. Get into it and get behind it.
Kia's Gear Up and Save event is on now at Kia Vancouver. So come score on most 2015 models with ultra-low weekly payments and 0% financing for 84 months. Plus, get ready for victory with Kia's available winter-ready features. But hurry, this is a limited-time offer. So gear up and save. And remember, only Kia Vancouver gives you free lifetime car washes, oil changes, and free airport shuttle and parking with your new Kia purchase. Kia Vancouver, Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon, and KiaVancouver.com.
Nearly 70 years ago, Charlie Wolford first started fixing Logger's boots. He did such a good job, Logger said if he'd make boots from scratch, they'd buy them and tell their buddies. Charlie named his brand Dayton. And ever since, Dayton Boots has put the same craftsmanship and love in every pair built right here in Vancouver. Times change, but the quality in every handcrafted pair of Dayton boots never has. Mention Kia Vancouver Soccer Talk and take 10% off Dayton boots. 2250 East Hastings. Dayton, where a legend that lasts.
Not that your stylist at the salon isn't doing a good job, but man, you deserve the big red leather barber chair experience of Barber & Co. Here's how it works. Go to barberandco.ca. Book your appointment at one of the five barber shops in Gastown, Yaletown, the Financial District, Cambie at 18th, and now Main Street and 12th Avenue. You can just walk in, too, and get your hair cut, hot shave, buzz cut, fade, or beard trim experience. A great wedding party idea, too. Barberandco.ca.
St. Joan, George Bernard Shaw's epic play, starts October 23rd at the Arts Club's Stanley Industrial Alliance stage. Revel in the legend of Joan of Arc and her remarkable rise and fall. Imaginatively staged and vividly rendered, this play about the inspiring life of a heroine will move and enthrall you 500 years after her controversial death. Tickets start from just $29 at artsclub.com. Don't miss St. Joan. That's artsclub.com.
When I need that perfect bottle of wine for a gift, I trust My Liquor Store.
When I want to try a new craft beer, I always go to My Liquor Store.
When I need advice on pairings, the advice is always spot on at My Liquor Store.
My neighborhood.
My Liquor Store.
Great pricing, knowledgeable staff, three convenient boutique locations open 7 days a week. Denman at Barclay, Abbott Street between Kiefer and Pender, and Burrard at 8th for great offers and special arrivals. Follow My Liquor Store on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on CIL 650. Now broadcasting from the Barber & Co. studios, here's your host, Tyler Grain.
Headlines from around the globe in a second, but first, Simon's got some scores from England.
Yes, games today, Manchester City beating Spurs by 4-1. It was Arsenal 2, Hull City 2, Crystal Palace losing at home to the leader Chelsea 2-1, Southampton 8, Sunderland 0. And two games tomorrow, QPR against Liverpool, Stoke against Swansea, and on Monday, West Brom host Manchester United.
That was for DonnellyGroup.ca. Now, around the globe, from snclubs.com, Bayern Munich manager Pep Guardiola is being chased by Manchester City, despite Guardiola saying that he would love to manage Manchester United. Harry Redknapp has been told he needs to make some big calls if he wants to keep his job at Loftus Road. And Simon, you got a few TFC notes and rumors.
Yeah, Gilberto doesn't sound like he's very happy at BMO Field, and rumors were going around that he wants to be on his way out. And Danilo Henry seems to be courting interest from clubs in Europe, from the sounds of it. And so of the potential player movement that could be happening with the Reds, he could be one that could be heading out the door as well.
And a derby in the NASL between two clubs, Canadian derby.
Yes, that's right. And the FC Edmonton went into TD Place in Ottawa today and beat the Ottawa Fury by 2-0. You know, very important win for them. They've been going really well, Colin Miller's side, and they are very much in the hunt to make the NASL playoffs. They're only 2 points off fourth place, which is where they really need to get to in the combined standings. So, very good win today for the Eddies.
Right now, Kia Vancouver offering free oil changes, car washes, airport parking and shuttle service. It's only at BC's number one Kia dealership. Kia Vancouver, 396 Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon, kiavancouver.com. Coming up, a conversation with Sportsnet.ca's John Molinaro about the continuing woes of TFC. But up next, expert physios David Sandals to chat injuries next.
Follow us on Twitter at SoccerTalk650 and at TylerGreenFC. This is Kia Vancouver's Soccer Talk on CIL 650.
Kia's Gear Up and Save event is on now at Kia Vancouver. So come score on most 2015 models with ultra-low weekly payments and 0% financing for 84 months. Plus, get ready for victory with Kia's available winter-ready features. But hurry, this is a limited-time offer. So gear up and save. And remember, only Kia Vancouver gives you free lifetime car washes, oil changes, and free airport shuttle and parking with your new Kia purchase. Kia Vancouver, Southwest Marine Drive at Yukon, and KiaVancouver.com.
Whether playing soccer on this continent or football on every other,
Umbro is the name worn by top players and teams worldwide. Those same uniforms are available for your team or club at Umbro.com. Umbro, proud to be the official supplier of Canada's men's and women's national teams, is celebrating 90 years of expertise in the game. If you want your club to play like the pros, dress them like the pros at Umbro.com. Umbro, the heart and soul of football.
The Straight Razor Shave, a leading man classic. Steady hand coaxing the rugged face back to smoothness. This nearly lost art has found revival at Barber & Co. Hot towel, straight edge blade, and your face. It's an experience that reminds you you're alive. You're a man in the company of history's finest men. Start at barberandco.ca. Pick your barber shop in Yale Town, Gastown, the Financial District, Cambie at 18th, and now Main Street and 12th Avenue. And relax into the big leather chair for the shave of your life.
What do you want?
A balcony so high it looks down into soccer matches at BC Place.
A pub I can walk to with a dozen big screens.
Kevin O'Toole has created findaproperty.ca to help you find it. Designed to be simply straightforward, findaproperty.ca is an invaluable tool. That's Kevin O'Toole, Prudential Sussex Realty, for buyers and sellers in the greater Vancouver area like you. So find what you want.
A backyard big enough for my own soccer pitch.
At findaproperty.ca.
How do you sell a diamond necklace you inherited or that diamond ring after the divorce? Canadian Estate Diamonds.
Canadian Estate Diamonds offers the highest prices for fine diamonds and gold and three liquidation scenarios to suit your needs. Same-day payment via certified check, consignment website, or auction.
When it's time to sell, learn more at CanadianEstateDiamonds.com.
Join Canadian Estate Diamonds on Sea Isle 650's Boomer Life this Monday at 6. Other Boomer Life Monday sponsors include Rivera Retirement Living and Mainland Hearing.
Hi, I'm Jack McIver. Summer has passed, and if you need a fantastic washer and dryer, our Speed Queen products are built better, like a 3-year full guarantee, 5 years on the motor, and 10 years on the washer transmission. Built in Ripon, Wisconsin, USA since the 1900s, no one now has washers and dryers that perform as well. McIvers have sold Speed Queen built washers and dryers for over 50 years, and they have no computers, only heavy duty timers. McIvers, 610 Southeast Marine Drive, call 879-5222 or find us on the net at McIvers.com.